I'm going to show you how to stream on PS4 using Streamlabs OBS without the need of a capture card. This will allow you to fully customize your live streams to add different scenes, custom transitions, alerts, and more. Let's do this. To begin with, turn on your PS4 and create a second account. We'll be using this second account to feed through the gameplay to the streaming software so that you can play your game on your main account as you always would without any form of lag. This second account does not need PS Plus. On that second account, go to Settings, then Account Management, and then Activate as Primary PS4 and click Activate. Also make sure that you are signed into your main account on your PS4 as well. Now you've done that, keep your PS4 turned on and head on over to your computer. To be able to do this properly, you will need to install a few different applications. One of those is of course the streaming software you will be using, and for this video I'll be using Streamlabs, which is available on Windows and Macs, but you can also install something else like standard OBS. With Streamlabs installed, now head over to the official PS4 Remote Play site and install PS4 Remote Play for your device. This is also available on both Windows and Mac devices, and I'll also provide links to all of these downloads required in the description. Once PS4 Remote Play is installed, open the software and click on Settings at the bottom left. Doing so should open a settings window. Under the PlayStation Network section, you now want to click on Sign In, and here you should sign into the second account that we just created at the start of the video. This is not the account you will be playing on, so don't sign into your main account here by mistake. Make sure it's a second account. The rest of this settings menu is where you are going to choose what quality your gameplay will be on stream. On the standard PS4 and PS4 Slim, you can select up to 720p at 60fps, and on the PS4 Pro, you can also select 1080p. However, don't just select the highest unless your internet connection can definitely handle it. Sony recommend you have at least a 12 megabit per second download speed, as well as a 12 megabit per second upload speed for Remote Play to run smoothly. If you don't quite meet these speeds or want a faster connection, then I do actually have a video on how you can increase your PS4 internet speed, so be sure to give that a go by clicking the video on screen now. If you only just meet these speeds, then try 720p at a standard frame rate. If you have a great internet connection though, then try to do this at the highest quality available. This is something you should really play around with to find the perfect settings. For me personally, I will be choosing 1080p, and then I'll just be choosing the standard frame rate option, as 30fps looks fine on stream for the games I'll be playing. When you're happy with everything, just click on OK. For this next part, click on Start and see if you connect to PS4 Remote Play. I asked PlayStation support on Twitter if you can connect without a controller, and they said it does sometimes work. For me, it actually always works, so give it a shot. However, if it does not work for you, then you will need to plug in a second controller, not the one you want to use to play, into your PC and then connect. If you don't have a spare controller, then you can use an emulator. However, the setup for that is quite complex, so if you do happen to be unfortunate enough to be in a position where connecting without a controller didn't work, then let me know in the comments and I'll walk you through the entire process. Anyway, once you've clicked start, you will connect to your PS4 and see the PS4 home screen. Now what you want to do is take your controller you want to play with and connect it to your PS4, and when you are asked which account you would like to sign into, choose your main account that you want to play games on whilst you're streaming. It is worth mentioning that you can do all of this whilst looking at your main PS4 display, and you don't have to do it via Remote Play. We actually use this second account so that you can play on your main PS4 display with your main controller, so you don't have to suffer input lag by using Remote Play. Your PS4 is now fully set up for this, so now I'm going to walk you through setting up the stream on Streamlabs, and then after that I'll show you a few other things, such as how to get your mic audio and party chat on the live stream. Before opening Streamlabs, it is critical that you do not minimize the Remote Play window, as if you do this, it won't work. So just open up Streamlabs and don't touch the Remote Play window. With the streaming software open, first off we will make sure you have the best settings. To alter your Streamlabs settings, click the settings wheel at the very bottom left of the window. The first thing we need to make sure is set up correctly is under the Stream tab. This is where you choose where you stream to and connect to the Streamlabs software to your stream. Select streaming services and then select where you want to stream to. You will then need to paste your unique stream key, which you can get from the live dashboard or settings of the site you intend to stream to. It's very important you do not share this key with anyone, as that means anyone could just go live on your account. Next up, go down to a video tab and choose whatever resolution and frame rate you connected to remote player. So as I connected to PS4 remote player at 1080p 30fps, I'll be making my output scaled resolution to 1080p and then my frame rate is going to be set to 30. I also recommend you have the canvas resolution on the same as the scaled output. Finally, in this settings window, go up to the output tab. Here, I strongly advise you select one of the hardware options as your encoder, and then you can change your bitrate here as well. If you find your stream is too laggy, then try lowering the bitrate. If it runs fine, then you could try increasing it until it starts to cause issues, at which point you would lower it back down just a little. This makes sure you are getting the best possible quality on your stream that your internet can handle. Once you are happy with all of these settings, simply click done. With all your settings correct, we now need to add everything into the stream. In the Streamlabs software, you have your scenes on the left that you can create and switch between. I advise you rename the default scene to PS4, and then focus on the sources section in the middle. Here, click the add icon and then select window capture. You should then call this window capture PS4, and then under window, add remoteplay.x PS4 remote play. Also uncheck the option to capture a cursor and then click done. You should now see your PS4 screen on the stream preview. If you don't, double check that you did not minimize the remote play window by selecting it on the taskbar and then just clicking outside of the window anywhere on Streamlabs. Then with remote play now properly open, try adding the window capture again. If it still doesn't appear on screen or it isn't full screen, then right click on it, go to transform and click fit to screen. If you want to add music or an overlay to your stream, click on the same add icon and then select media source. Then look for your music or overlay in your files and add them to the scene. You can then drag an overlay however you want and you can change the volume of the music on the right. It is worth mentioning that if your overlay is a static image, then you should instead add this via the image source. Adding screens such as a Be Right Back screen or a Stream Offline screen is also very simple. Create a new scene on the left by clicking the add icon next to the scenes, name it whatever you like, and then you can add a media source to this in the same way we just added the overlay music. But this time choose a screen you want to show instead. You can then flick between the scenes by selecting them on the left. If you want the cool stinger transition to make swapping between scenes super smooth, then click the settings wheel above the scenes area, and then click the pencil icon to edit the transition. You should then choose the stinger option as the transition type, and then add the transition you want to use from your files, and tweak the duration to match your specific transition. If you want a clean stinger transition like the one you see me using, then I do actually make these for a really low price on Fiverr. I will link that in the description below. In terms of adding other things to your stream, such as alerts, all of that is done in the same pop-up you get when you add a media capture source. There are some default alerts which you can select when you add your widgets via the sources tab. Once you are happy with everything and ready to go live, you just simply press the go live button at the bottom right of Streamlabs and you will be broadcast to the world. Only 2.8% of my viewers are actually subscribed to my channel, and I really think we should try to get this number up. So if this video does help you out and you want to see more essential PlayStation tips, tricks and guides, then make sure to hit that subscribe button as well as enable all notifications. If you wish to get your microphone and also party audio on the livestream and you only have access to one microphone, then you will need to disconnect your mic from your PS4 and plug it directly into your PC. Pretty much every mic or headset for PS4 does also work on PC, so if you are unsure on how to connect your exact device properly to your computer, then check the instructions manual. With the mic connected, go to settings, then system, then sound, and change the output to your headset. And then also change the input to your mic. You should now hear all of the PS4 audio coming through your headset you just connected to your PC. To get your mic audio on stream, click the settings wheel next to the mic source under mixer, then select properties and change your microphone to the one you connected. You should also double check that the desktop audio capture is working and showing audio. If not, do the same on that and select the device the audio is currently playing through. To be able to speak to your party and also get the party chat on the stream at the same time, go to your remote play window and click the mic icon at the bottom right to unmute the remote play microphone. Before doing this, make sure you don't have any other microphones connected to the PS4 directly, and also mute the PS camera if you do have one connected. Then join the party on the second account via remote play, as well as your main account you are playing on. All party audio should now also be received on your PC, so you can hear your friends, your stream can hear your your friends, and you can also hear all party chat and game audio perfectly. Now, if you only have one display, so you can't play on your PS4 and switch scenes at the same time, then you can instead install the Streamlabs Deck app on your phone. This is what I personally use, and it lets you use your phone just like a Stream Deck. And at a click of any button, you can easily switch between your scenes, mute sources, change volume, and do everything you could if you had a double monitor setup. If any of you have any questions about this or are experiencing any issues, then please let me know in the comments as I will respond to you. If you want to know how to improve your PS4 FPS, then click the video on screen now. Also, if this video did help you out in any way, please leave a like and also consider subscribing with all notifications turned on to ensure you never miss out on any PlayStation tips, tricks, and guides. Anyway, that's all from me in this video, and I'll see you in the next one.